Visualization of the needle is extremely important for ultrasound-guided central venous access. This video, we will discuss three methods of visualizing the needle as it approaches a vein. The first technique is called the out-of-plane approach. In this approach, the needle as well as the vein are seen in cross-section, with the needle appearing as a dot and the vein appearing as a circle deep on the screen. The needle is placed under the long face of the transducer as close to the transducer as possible until the needle is seen at the top of the screen. The needle is then walked down to the vein. Walking the needle towards the vein means you move the probe until the needle tip cannot be seen anymore, and then slide the needle into the plane of the vein. The needle will appear at that point as a bright dot. Once the needle is seen, stop moving the needle and slide the transducer further up the vein. This process is repeated until the needle is centered in the vein lumen. This is walking the needle towards the vein. The probe is moved up the vein, then the needle slid into view. Probe, then needle. An error may occur with this approach in that the needle tip may not be visualized all the way down to the vein. This occurs when the probe is not advanced ahead of the needle and the needle tip is lost in the soft tissue. What often occurs is the needle will pass through the back wall of the vein and occasionally into the artery, which may be posterior to the vein. This can lead to disastrous results. Here we see the IJ vein next to the carotid artery. The needle has been inserted all the way to the hub and you cannot see the needle tip as it is deep to the vein. In this case, the physician did not follow the needle tip down towards the vein and lost the needle tip in the soft tissue. They confounded this error by continuing to slide the needle when the needle tip was not visualized. In this case, there was no harm to the patient. However, if the carotid artery had been posterior to the IJ vein, an arterial puncture could have occurred. The second technique is the in-plane or long axis approach. In this approach, the transducer is turned parallel to the vein. The needle is placed under the short face of the transducer and it appears as a long thin line. When all three structures, the transducer, the needle, and the vein, are lined up, the needle tip can easily be seen entering the anterior wall of the vein and not puncturing the posterior wall. This technique is thought to be safer as posterior wall penetrations occur less frequently since the needle is seen as in entirety. Common mistake with this technique is misidentification of the artery and the vein. Veins can only be identified in short axis where they appear as a circle. The transducer is placed on top of the vein and veins will collapse easily with pressure. Arteries will not collapse unless a lot of pressure is used. Veins are not identified in long axis. Veins are identified in short axis and then the transducer is turned from short axis to long axis while visualizing the vein on the screen the entire time. Veins can never be differentiated from arteries in long axis. Many people make the mistake of sliding off the vein in the long axis and thinking they are collapsing the vein, as they do in short axis. They are not really collapsing the vein, they may be sliding off the artery. If the artery is misidentified as a vein, serious complications can occur. Again, the pitfall of the in-plane or long axis approach is misidentification of the artery as a vein when turning from short axis to long axis. The pitfall of the out-of-plane or cross-sectional approach is not following the needle tip all the way down to the vein and losing the needle tip in the soft tissue. The third approach, we call the mixed technique, combines the best of the in-plane and the best of the out-of-plane techniques to avoid complications. In this technique, we start off in short axis and do the compression technique to identify the vein. Then we walk the needle down towards the vein. When the needle is just above the vein, we can turn to long axis or the in-plane approach. Since the needle is localizing the vein, we know that we are looking at the vein in long axis when we see the needle just above the vessel. Once we visualize the vein and the needle in long axis, we can insert the needle into the anterior wall of the vein and avoid a posterior penetration. In this video, you can see how difficult it is to see the needle in short axis. However, we can tell that the needle is just above the vein. And when we switch to long axis, we can see the needle in its entirety and guide it down into the vein and not penetrate the posterior wall. This mixed technique is the preferred method of using ultrasound to visualize the needle for accessing a central vein. It eliminates misidentification of the vein while also reducing the risk of posterior wall penetration. Thank you very much. I'm Matt Lyon. Please contact me at the Center for Ultrasound Education and Research if you have any questions.